As we're approaching the seasons of cold weather in the UK, this is the time when using heating and hot water becomes more prolific, and so do the dangers of carbon monoxide. In this video, we'll talk about what carbon monoxide is, what causes it, how it affects the body, how you can protect yourself, and the importance of choosing the right carbon monoxide alarm. So please keep watching.
Don't forget to check out our other videos on everything campervan and motorhome related, from solar to water, heating to gadgets, tyres to trips. If you like this video, please do hit the thumbs up. It really does help me to know what you like, and you can ask any questions or give feedback in the comments. If you want to make sure you don't miss any of our future videos, please hit the subscribe button, and clicking the bell will give you a notification when a new video goes live. Finally, if you do decide to hit the thumbs down, it would be great if you could also leave a comment so I know what you didn't like.
As the topic of this video is so important, you're probably wondering, why does this guy think he can tell me about carbon monoxide? And I can totally understand that. So just to add a little bit of credibility, although it is some years ago now, I did study human biology. As a qualified advanced nitrox diver, I have to demonstrate a good understanding of the human respiratory and pulmonary systems and the effects that gases have on us. And as a rescue medic trained in immediate emergency care, I have to understand the physical mechanism of carbon monoxide poisoning to help with treating it. So with that out of the way, let's start with, what is carbon monoxide and why is it dangerous?
Carbon monoxide is a colourless, odourless and tasteless gas. It's produced when any fossil fuel is not burnt properly. So the fuels that we often use in camper vans, like propane, butane, diesel, petrol, coal or wood, could produce it. Here we can see an example of complete combustion of a fuel in sufficient oxygen. The products of combustion are carbon dioxide and water. Where there is incomplete combustion due to insufficient oxygen, which could be due to an appliance that is of poor quality, set up incorrectly, poorly maintained, or installed incorrectly or inappropriately, the products of combustion here are carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and water. The effect of carbon monoxide on the human body is significant. Hemoglobin in blood absorbs oxygen from the lungs, forming oxyhemoglobin. However, if the air you breathe has a concentration of carbon monoxide, this has approximately 240 times more affinity to bind to the hemoglobin than oxygen, and this forms carboxyhemoglobin. This blocks the hemoglobin's ability to absorb oxygen. Oxyhemoglobin is distributed via the bloodstream to supply oxygen from the lungs to your tissues and vital organs. If a proportion of that oxyhemoglobin is now carboxyhemoglobin, there's far less oxygen to be distributed, leading to a lack of oxygen to the organs and tissues. As it takes on average 4 hours for the levels of carboxyhemoglobin in the blood to reduce by half, it means that carbon monoxide is not only dangerous at high concentrations, but can also allow carboxyhemoglobin to build up in the bloodstream over time from lower concentrations for a prolonged period or regular exposure. The symptoms you can expect to see from exposure to carbon monoxide are headaches, vomiting, difficulty breathing, lethargy, confusion, dizziness, collapse, and loss of consciousness. Ultimately, exposure can lead to permanent brain damage and death. If you suspect someone of having carbon monoxide poisoning, it's vital to get them into clear, uncontaminated air, seek immediate medical assistance, and be prepared to give CPR. The Office of National Statistics show that the death rate in the UK from unintentional carbon monoxide poisoning has reduced in recent years, but there are still over 100 deaths a year. And if we look at the fuel source that caused the death over the last 5 years, we see a large proportion of these are solid fuel, like coal, wood or charcoal, portable gas, petrol or diesel. All fuels that are often used in campervans, motorhomes, caravans and while camping. There are key ways to protect yourself from carbon monoxide. For any appliance that burns a fossil fuel, be it gas, diesel, wood, coal or anything else, ensure it is appropriately approved for how you plan to use it and fitted to the manufacturer's instructions. Follow any guidance on the use of your individual installation. For example, when running our water heater on gas, we don't open this window as recommended by this sticker. Never use appliances designed for outside use inside, or bring charcoal barbecues inside a van or awning, even when you think they are cool. Although it's not a legal requirement in the UK, unless you are producing campervan conversions commercially or hiring them out, ideally appliances should be safety checked after installation and regularly serviced. This will ensure they are installed safely and ensure combustion continues to be complete as the appliance ages. Installation of an appropriate carbon monoxide alarm can give an early warning of dangerous levels of carbon monoxide and should be fitted. But they shouldn't be relied upon to make up for poor condition or inappropriately installed appliances. Personally, I classify carbon monoxide alarms into three categories: dangerous, domestic, and mobile. In my dangerous category, that I would urge you to avoid, there are a surprising amount of alarms which are mainly unbranded and available from online marketplaces. When independently tested by Which magazine, they were found to have serious issues, which meant they would not always activate an alarm in concentrations of carbon monoxide that would be classified as dangerous. The next category are domestic. These are alarms that are designed and made to the BSEN 50291-1 2018 standard. They've been tested for performance, accuracy, durability, alarm volume, impact of air temperature and reaction time, but only when used in continuous static positions in a domestic premise. Whilst these will be suitable for use in the home, they are not tested for use in a vehicle. Mobile alarms are tested to BSEN 50291-2 2020. Alarms meeting this standard must meet the domestic standard and also satisfy additional tests to demonstrate their reliability and suitability where they are subject to movement or vibration, and in general will be more robust than alarms only meeting the domestic standard, making them more suitable for use in vehicles. It is only alarms that meet this standard that I would recommend for use in a van, camper, motorhome or caravan. You can find links to some alarms that meet the mobile standard in the video notes. Once you have an alarm installed, don't forget to test it at least once a month and follow the manufacturer's instructions for any periodic maintenance.
I hope that helps you to understand the risks of carbon monoxide and some of the simple things you can do to keep you and your loved ones safer from it. In my next video, I'll share my thoughts on the contentious topic of non-room sealed tankless water heaters. So make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss it.
Thanks for watching our video, and as always, if you have any questions or feedback, please pop them in the comments below. If you find the video useful, please like, share, and consider subscribing.